Julia Gillard for making these gaps.
Although I'd love to be a voice for my people in Parliament, I think time and place for everything, and I think that we have strong elders and strong people who are older that we can push in there, and maybe my time will come in the future, but I'm happy doing the activism work. We just have so much fun, and it's really hard and it's sad, but at the end of the day, we're fighting for a cause that is going to benefit everybody, you know, not just those who want the money and power.
Prime Minister and Mr. Abbott to come and join them for lunch.
Pretty much a donation system, and if people can afford to donate, they do. But it's just, I don't know, I just get the feeling it's all running on love.
Thank you. Okay, we're 1 week into the walk away from uranium mining and sitting at the crossroads near the Yuliri homestead. It's morning time and a busload of walkers who've been in solidarity with for the first week are returning to Perth.
My name is Gary Harris. I'm a Wangwal Dalal lady elder. I came here to support the footprint at here at Yuliri to stop uranium mining, like my elders did back in the 70s. Also, the anti-nuclear campaign.
Sitting with me is Marianne Mackay, who was a candidate for the First Nations People's Party last year and is also guest in custody. Chairperson, good morning.
Good morning.
Can you tell us what led you to coming on the walk?
Well, my sister girl, Galloway Morrison, who's our chairperson for the West Australian Nuclear Free Alliance, got me involved with the anti-uranium campaign last year in 2010. And through that, I met Marcus and KA, and through their work for Footprints for Peace, they organised a walk. Talking about climate change and everything like that and the lack of water, and yet we have governments who intend on letting international companies come here and drain the precious groundwater that we do have just for them to mine uranium. It's going to destroy the culture and totally oppress our people, and we just have no rights at all when it comes to mining, and we can't even say no. If we do say no, then they'll just come and take the land, and there's no benefit at all for Aboriginal people. They'll just lose the land with no nothing, you know, no benefit from it. It only benefits the government, and it benefits them in the sense of money, and it benefits the shareholders of the companies that want to mine uranium. And the land's illegally occupied anyway, because it was never conquered or ceded or terra nullius.
That's it. Over here, guys, over here. Thanks, mate.
I just can't understand how they can do it and just get away with it. They're not going to win. And there's so much strength within the camp, and it's just such diverse, you know, a diverse range of people. It's just awesome to see people from all different worlds and on an international level as well coming together and supporting our people in our struggle. Bring all of these people to Aboriginal country, and yet our people are being silent.
Where are you from, actually? Australian. I would expect that you would know that. And I would expect that you would. There's the media statement, all right?
Aboriginal elders say the Prime Minister wasn't their target. Their anger was directed at Tony Abbott, who they believe wants the Tent Embassy torn down.
The Tent Embassy is actually set up in 1972 for Aboriginal rights, for our sovereignty. Because we are sovereign people on sovereign land. That's what we are.
They know, as the First Nations peoples and traditional owners of this country, that we have every right to speak. Colin Barnett and his Liberal government intent on destroying, you know, such a beautiful wilderness such as James Price Point.
But we're not going to have Jackie Jackies up here in the Parliament
anyway,
some kind of false committee. They think they've been the self-appointed people leaders in our community, going around promoting things here that we never even thought of in the first place. Someone else told them that.
Colin Barnett has, you know, the Cottesloe electorate in Perth, and he's intent on heritage listing a developed beach that has buildings, but yet he refuses to heritage list and have respect for the culture and the dreaming of James Price Point. As the Premier of this state, I think the Liberal government needs to have shame for themselves. And they sent up, you know, about 30 riot police to the Kimberley to support the mining company. Like, we voted for them, so they're supposed to be representing the people. And it just shows what such a capitalist state that we live in. Beautiful wilderness such as James Price Point.